Great to see you. Hello, welcome to Light on Lotus. My name is Kate, and we're gonna work our way up the chakra system today. So we're gonna start with the root and work our way up to the crown. We're gonna live in the second and third chakras for a while though. I'm partial to them. So take your hands together like this with your index fingers extended and reach your index fingers down into the ground. So this is the gesture of pouring out and letting go. We're gonna slow down our breath here. So you'll inhale through the nose, take your time filling up all the way. You might pause at the top of your inhalation. And then you'll exhale through the nose, nice and slow. And we're gonna focus our attention on the bottoming out. You're holding the breath out. It's Vaya Kumbhaka. This moment where sort of move into the void, let go, and trust that the next breath will come, and it will. And when it needs to come, let it come. Breathe it in through the nose. Pausing at the top of the inhalation and emptying back out. Then holding the breath out for as long as you're comfortable. Letting go of what no longer serves you, making space for something new. And then take it in slowly. One last round, emptying out. So things you are holding on to unnecessarily could just drain out of your fingertips away from your body into the earth. And with your next breath in, we'll ohm it out. So draw it in, filling up. Open and change the crossing of your legs. Take your hands on your knees and start to swirl around clockwise. So breathe in to the front of the mat and circle around to the back in the Sufi grind. Yeah, so as you spiral around your center, imagine your tailbone sort of like a corkscrew winding its way down into the ground. Rocking through the sitting bones, unlocking the hips, churning through the navel, allowing the shoulders to move with you. And then you can reverse the flow, go the other direction. It's almost like a little whirlpool you're creating with the movement. And you can slide your hands just down below the knees onto the shins. Inhale, move your heart forward and roll the shoulders back. And then exhale, pull the navel back toward the spine. Yeah, so take a hold of your shins right there. Breathing in, rock forward. Shoulder blades slide together down the back. And then breathing out, pull the navel back, chin into the chest. A few more of those, just getting the movement of the spine to link up with the breath. And then with your next breath in, take your arms up, stretch your spine long out of your hips, circle your hands behind you onto the mat, plant your feet forward and lift the hips for tabletop. And let out a lion's breath here. And lower yourselves down, cross your legs, come out onto all fours, and then sink back into child's pose for a few breaths. getting nice and close to the ground. If you can rest your third eye on the ground, allow your head to rock right to left just a little bit, almost like you're grounding your third eye, your intuition, giving it weight. And you're gonna slide into a baby cobra from here. So slither on out like a snake. Just watch out for your water bottles or whatever else might be out at the front of your mat. And then press into the tops of the feet, energize your legs and float your hands up off the mat. Yeah, so you're awakening the back body here. And then you can plant the hands back down, press back over your knees, tuck your toes, and ease back into downward dog. So you can pedal out on your way there, bending one knee then the other. Channeling your four-legged friends. And then send the inner edges of the heels down and slide the inner thighs toward the back wall with a little more energy, yeah. You can come through plank pose on a breath in, move the heart forward. Child's pose, breathing out. Sit your hips to your heels, feel a nice deep crease at the tops of the thighs. Slide through to cobra, breathing in. You might float the hands up off the mat again. And then downward facing dog, breathing out. Tucking the toes, moving back over the knees. From here, come into a plank one more time. Child's pose, sink back. When you come up to all fours, you'll lift your right leg, breathing in. So you can lift your gaze forward too, yeah. And then draw the knee into the nose and round the spine on the breath out. So there's a lift through the navel as you curl into yourself. Send the right leg high. And then take your right knee to your upper right arm. So it's gonna go pretty wide, rolling the thigh bone out in the socket. And then send your right leg back behind you. Inhaling, lift your gaze. Now bring your right knee to your left arm. So it kind of cuts across the middle, a little more crowded. Send the right leg back behind you and actually tip your right heel to the back of the mat behind your left foot and lift your right hand. Maybe take it behind your head so you can press into the right foot and reach your right elbow to the front of the room, stretching through the waist. And then take the right hand back down to the floor. Bring your right foot to the outside of the right hand. Yeah, and come up to your fingertips here. So it's nice and wide. The right foot might be on the edge of the mat. Lift your chest, move the hips forward, and then with an exhale, straighten the right leg and flex through the right foot. Oh yeah. And that's it, back and forth a few times, coming through a nice wide lunge, the knee heading over the toes, and then exhaling into a crooked Ardha Hanumanasana shape. Inhaling, shift forward, bending the right knee to the outside of the right arm, and exhaling your way back. Nice and close to Mama Earth. Come back into your lunge one more time. Now from here, tuck your left toes. Lift your left knee up off the mat. Yeah. Now press your right knee to your upper right arm. You might have to walk the foot in a little closer. And see if you can lift your right heel up towards your right booty. Oh, hey. Yeah, and then downward facing, step it back. Whew. Plank pose on your inhale. Lower to the mat in one piece on your exhale. Cobra breathing in, roll the shoulders back, stretch the front body. And then back to child's pose, breathing out. Come up to all fours and lift the left leg this time, breathing in. Take your knee into your nose, connect your navel and round the spine on the breath out. Send the left leg high, inhale. Now take your knee to your upper left arm, go wide. left leg high, breathing in, spread your fingers out, and then take your knee to your right upper arm, breathing out. Ooh, send the left leg back behind you. Turn the heel down to the floor and inhale the left arm up. So it's like a little kickstand, almost like a side plank preparation. Someday it'll be a side plank. And take your hand behind your head, tip your elbow up toward the stage and reach through the pinky toe edge of the left foot to get more space in the waist. Yes, people. Now circle the left hand back down. Good. Lift the left leg. Take it wide. Take your left foot all the way to the outside of the left hand. Yeah. So it's a little bit animalistic at this point. Come into a lunge, breathing in. So lift your chest, lift your chin, and then with your exhale, straighten through the left leg. You can tent your fingers or even use blocks if you feel like the floor is too far away. Flex the foot and feel the connection between the left heel and the base of your spine. And then move back and forth with your breath. Lunging on the inhale, washing the hips back, flexing the left foot, exhaling. Breathing in and breathing out. Connecting to your root system, your legs, your feet. And then we'll lunge forward, plant your hands into the mat, tuck your right toes, lift the right knee up with an inhale. Press your left knee to the upper left arm like a little Velcro. And then with your next inhale, lift your left heel. Ooh. Downward dog, exhaling, send your legs back. Lift the navel in and up. And then plank pose, breathing in. Lower to the mat in one piece. Breathing out. Cobra, you might grow a little higher off the ground. Could happen. Downward facing, breathing out. Tuck your toes, send your hips high. Right leg to the sky, yogis, breathing in, lift it up. Bend the right knee, roll the hip open, and reach your left heel down with a little bit more juice, yeah. And then you're gonna take your right knee to your upper right arm with the breath in. Yeah, so we're kind of reversing where we just were. Step it to the outside of the right hand, breathing out. Inhale the right arm this time, lift it to the sky, and twist from your belly. Now we're gonna step the left foot to the outside of the left hand into Malasana, oh hey. Right arm under the left arm, eagle arms. So it's a big old squat at the top of the mat, yeah. Now reach into the feet, folks, rise up, breathing in, lift up high. Come back down and release your hands to the mat. Inhale, step the right leg to the back of the mat, the heart can reach forward. Downward facing dog from here, send your hips high. Plank pose on the inhale. Lower halfway chaturanga on your exhale. Upward facing dog, point your feet, roll the shoulder heads back, lift your thighs. And then downward facing dog, tuck your toes, send your hips high. Left leg lifts, breathing in. Bend the left knee, roll the hip open, but get really long through the right waist. As you move the right heel down, yeah. Inhale the left knee to the upper left arm. Keep your stomach strong. Bring your knee to your upper left arm and then step your foot to the outside of the hand. Left arm lifts on an inhale. So twist, but you've got all this room. Your left leg's way out to the side. And then step your right foot to the outside of the right hand. Left arm weaves under the right arm. Eagle arms. Maybe that'll help you connect to center a little more. And then come all the way up to stand, breathing in. Root through the legs and feet evenly. Yes, yes. And then take your hands back to the mat as you sink down into your squat. Left leg steps back, breathing in. Move the heart forward. Downward facing dog, breathing out, hips high. Plank pose, inhaling. Chaturanga, exhaling. Splash it open, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, back over the toes to Adho Mukha Svanasana. Let's take a full breath in here. Let it out through the mouth. And you're gonna rise up to the balls of the feet. Inhaling, gaze forward. See if you can step or float maybe lightly to your squat. Ah, go wide, Liz. There you go. So Malasana, feet wide, yes. So this is like our earth pose. Now from here, take your fingertips out in front of you, tent the fingers. You're gonna turn the toes parallel as you straighten the legs. So keep the feet wide, lift the heart here. And then make peace signs and see if you can wrap those peace signs around the inside of your big toes, yogi toe lock, with the thumbs planted on the inside of the toes toward the middle of the mat. So it's somewhere between a straddle forward fold and uttanasana, standing forward fold, but much wider. You can lift your chest, breathing in, and then bend the elbows out to the sides and drop yourself a little deeper into the shape. Yeah, shifting your weight into the balls of the feet. Just feeling that nice strong foundation underneath you, stability with the wider stance. You can let go of your toes, inhale your way up to stand, reaching down to rise up. So you're gonna take the mudra we started with, index fingers extended, thumbs crossed. The feet are parallel, stationary crow. So the knees will bend, make a straight line with your spine. The tailbone reaches to the back of the room, the index fingers reach to the front of the room. And see if you can flare the toes up off the mat. Yeah, to invite more energy in the lower legs and feet. Shoulder blades draw together, lift Mula Bandha, AKA your pelvic floor, and your belly as you sit your hips back even further. Slow down your breath. Feel the red heat building in your legs. Namaste, everyone. Inhale up to stand. Lift your heart and gaze, and then bring your hands down on your exhale. Open your hands by your sides. Be the mountain. And you're gonna take your feet together. You're gonna set up for the second chakra. Utkatasana, folks, breathing in, drop deep into the hips, swim the arms up high, dive forward, breathing out, fold in half. Lift your gaze, inhaling to a flat back, and then soften your knees, step or float your way back through Chaturanga, bending the elbows straight back to frame the ribs. Splash open on your inhale, upward facing dog, and then curl back over your toes on your exhale to downward facing dog. Inhale the right leg up, lift from your inner right thigh, and then place your foot just between your hands, so right at the top of the mat, between your hands, directly between your hands almost. There we go. And then spin your left heel down, circle open to warrior two. So we're coming right up, setting yourself up for a heel to heel or heel to arch alignment. And then from here, the left arm's gonna weave under the right arm. So the right arm can circle up over the top, find your eagle arms in warrior two. Inhaling, straighten your right leg, reach your fingertips to the sky and see if you can sort of tug the shoulder blades apart on your back. And with your exhale, bend the right knee, let the arms splash back open, warrior two, focus forward over your right fingertips. Tip it back into peaceful, reverse warrior with the breath in. So the right arm lifts, keep the knee stacked over the ankle, and then chaturanga or downward dog if you want to skip the vinyasa. So at any point, if you'd rather return to downward dog and skip the chaturanga, just know you're welcome to do that. Inhale the left leg to the sky. Step it directly between your hands on your exhale. Turn the right heel down, circle up to warrior two, stacking the shoulders over the hips, and then weave the right arm under the left arm. See if the hands can meet. With an inhale, reach long through the left leg and take your hands a little higher, lifting the rib cage up off the hips. Yeah, and then exhale, splash open, warrior two, nice and broad, yeah. Tip it back into reverse warrior. Keep the left thigh descending down as you open up the left ribs, and then take it down and move it through chaturanga or downward dog. So the second chakra is about water, it's about movement, it's about flow. Right leg to the sky, breathing in. Step it forward between your hands, breathing out. Circle open, warrior two, inhaling. Take the left arm under the right for eagle arms, exhaling. Inhale, straighten the right leg, reach your fingertips high, and then warrior two, drop it nice and deep, tracking the knee over the ankle. Peaceful warrior, breathing in, right arm lifts. Exhale your forearm to your thigh for extended side angle. And you can sweep the left arm overhead. Notch your left heel back a little bit, Annie. Good. Get a little longer through the right waist if you can. And then back into reverse warrior, breathing in, reach forward through the right shin. Chaturanga or downward dog, breathing out. Left leg lifts with your next inhale. Step it forward between your hands, exhaling. Warrior two, breathing in, circle it open. Right arm under the left, eagle arms. Inhale to straighten the left leg, lift your fingertips higher. Exhale to land back in a deep warrior two, wide open. Tip it back into reverse warrior, breathing in. Empty your forearm to your thigh, breathing out. You can rein in the front bottom ribs slightly, drawing the navel in and up toward the heart. And with your next breath in, take it back into your peaceful warrior, lifting the gaze as you reach the left shin forward. Take it down and move it through, breathing now. So I like to move around the mat, and with our next round, we're gonna end up facing the back for a bit. So heads up there. Right leg to the sky, breathing in. Step it through to the top, breathing out. Warrior two, inhaling. Now as you come into your eagle arms, the right toes turn in a little bit, the left toes turn out a little bit. Kali Ma, so bend both knees over the toes and add a lion's breath. And you might sway right to left a little here. So get into those hips, spiral the thighs out, work through the inner and the outer hips, and then slide your feet back toward the rear of the room, reverse warrior, breathing in. So the arms can splash open there, the right toes angle forward toward the left foot. Now straighten your left leg, you're gonna heel toe the right foot in just a bit, triangle pose at the back of the mat. So dock your hips back toward the stage. Just make sure you brought your right foot around with you. Yeah, so the right toes are angling toward the left. Yeah. Root through the ball of the left foot. Engage your left thigh. Nudge the left hip forward under the right hip. And then lengthen through the left waist. Reaching the crown of the head straight to the rear of the room as the tail reaches back to the front of the room. So beautiful parallel lines through the left and right waistline, intersecting with the vertical lines created by your arms. We'll inhale back into our reverse warrior. So we're gonna come through a fun shape. It's sort of like a high skandhasana, rainbow warrior. The right toes turn out to the front of the mat. Bend the right knee, flex the left foot, and bring your left hand to your heart. Yeah, so it's like a high skandhasana, a little bit of a side lunge. So you feel the external rotation in the right hip and maybe the lengthening through the left inner thigh. And then take your left hand to the top of the mat, tuck your left toes, inhale your right arm up to a twist. So the left toes have to tuck for the left heel to spin up. From here, heel toe the right foot down the right side of the mat. Heel toe, heel toe, heel toe. Pivot onto the outer edge of the left foot. You might stay here. You might come into side plank. Check it in. You might come into side plank with tree. Lots of options. Good. Keep the space in your left shoulder. You might step your right foot back into wild thing as long as you can stay lifted through the left shoulder. On your exhale, you can come through chaturanga, you can come through child's pose, or even downward dog. Moving with your breath. Celebrating the heat that we're building here in our bodies. And then send the left leg up with your next breath in. Step it forward between your hands, breathing out. circle open to warrior two, inhaling. Turn your right toes out, but your left toes in. Right arm under the left, Kali Ma, or temple pose. Drop down, let it out through the mouth in a lion's breath. Yeah. Try to head the knees right over the toes. So if your feet are too turned out, you might angle them in slightly so it's a little bit more natural feeling. Right. And then both feet angled to the back of the mat. Open the arms. Peaceful warrior or reverse warrior to the back of the mat. Start to straighten through the right leg. Lean forward with your right arm. Heel toe the left foot in just a notch. Send the hips back to the stage and reach your right arm down your right shin and your left arm to the sky. So you're welcome to take your hand anywhere between your knee and your ankle if the fingertips aren't touching the ground. And then bring the left arm back on to your shoulder. If it tends to fall off, you know who you are, the hypermobile shoulders. You can even imagine you're squeezing an invisible psychic beach ball between your inner thighs, everybody. And then we'll rise back up with an inhale into a reverse warrior. The left toes will turn back out to the front of the mat. Bend the left knee as you straighten through the right leg. Flex the right foot, bring your hand to your heart. Rainbow warrior or high skandhasana, yeah. So keep your rib cage lifted up off the hips. Now the right hand's coming back to the top of the mat. Tuck the right toes underneath you. Inhale the left arm up, turn from your navel so the right thigh rolls in, great. Heel toe the left foot all the way down the side of the mat, finding your side plank preparation on the edge of the right foot. And then maybe you lift the left leg, maybe you don't. Keep the right fingers active and gripping into the ground, engaging your arm muscles all the way up into the shoulder. Maybe step the left foot back, staying lifted up on the ball of the left foot and spacious in the right shoulder. And then again, on your way out, you can create closure in your own way. Child's pose, downward dog, chaturanga, as you wish. Yeah, take a full breath in all together. And empty it out with a sigh. It's all happening. And then rise up to the balls of the feet here, breathing and gaze forward. Step or float to the top of the mat. Inhale to a flat back, reach the heart forward. And then empty into your legs for Uttanasana. Let's come up through chair pose, inhaling, Utkatasana, sit nice and low. And then bring your hands to your heart, come to stand for a moment. In Tadasana, yes. So leaning into the right leg, you can bring your left knee into your chest. You can hug it close for a moment, even circle the left foot around. And then take your left leg, rotate it out, find your tree pose, planting the foot on the inside of the right leg. You might even branch out when you're feeling balanced. Yeah, let's soften up your expression. Nothing like a tense tree. Now we're gonna root down through the right leg and lift the left knee up toward the left armpit. So imagine kind of an air tree. Ah. And now the left leg will cross behind the right. Swing your arms back, cosmic curtsy. The left hand can come to the hip. Swing your right fingertips out in front of you. You might grab a block. You're going to turn your body open to the left for Ardha Chandrasana, or half moon pose. Yeah, flex your left foot powerfully. Nice, maybe you get so strong with the left leg and so lifted with the right waist that you take your hand up off the floor or off the block for a breath. Beautiful. Inhale back into peaceful warrior. Gracefully step your left foot back and circle your left arm down your left leg. And then we'll turn our feet back out into Kali Ma through the middle. Eagle arms. To the back of the mat. Angle both feet to the left. Inhale, the arms splash open again into your reverse warrior. one more triangle pose. You can straighten the left leg, heel toe the right foot in slightly. Slide your hand down, maybe a little further this time. Yeah. And we're gonna take that Skandasana shape, well, the Rainbow Warrior, into Skandasana, so it's gonna be a lot deeper. Reach your right arm overhead. Circle the right hand down. Now turn the right toes back to the front of the mat. This is a little weird, bear with me. Walk your hands to the right foot and bend the right knee at the front of the mat. Other way, Mara. Yes, good. So the left foot is flexed. Use your right arm on the inside of the right leg to keep the knee heading over the toes. Yeah, so it's, you know, fairly intense for most of us here. Good. So see if you can tent the right fingers out to the top of the mat and inhale the left arm up. If you need your hands on the ground, keep them there. You might even put a block under your booty. Some of you might be able to wrap your arms around your right shin in a bind. No pressure either way. Keep a lift through Mula Bandha, your root lock, and through your navel lock. Now release your hands back down to the mat. So you're literally picking yourself up. Angle your left toes to the front of the mat. Turn your right toes to the front of the mat. Extended side angle. You may want to put a block underneath your right hand. So we're going to try to take our hand flat. If it doesn't go flat, and for most of us it probably won't, then you use a block under your right hand. Reach your left arm to the sky. Okay, remember that air tree. We're gonna try it here. You're gonna lift your right heel towards your right sitting bone and press your right knee to your upper right arm. Yeah, it's no joke. Take your left hand down, tuck your left toes, spin to the outside of your left leg, side plank with your right leg lifted. Air tree here. Step it back, wild thing. Stay lifted out of your left shoulder, breathing in. Last thing, right hand down, right knee to the nose. Fall in triangle. So the hand goes to the outside of the left hand. Yes, Glenna. Spin it open one last time. Yes, people. Maybe chaturanga, maybe downward dog, maybe child's pose. Smoothing out the breath. We're gonna step or float to the top of the mat. Inhale, reach the heart forward. Empty into your legs, letting go. Chair pose, breathing in, sink low, swim the arms high, and then come to stand back in your mountain pose, Tadasana. You can open your hands. Let the energy settle. Leaning into the left leg, you can bring your right knee in. Stack the shoulders over the hips and then set up for your tree. So the right foot on the inside of the left leg. Level hips. Open arms. And then root down through your trunk so you can lift the right knee up. And step your right leg behind your left. Swing your arms back beside you. You can take your right hand to your hip. The left fingertips reach out in front of you. Half moon pose to the right side of the room. So the right leg stretches back. Standing on your left leg. Lift your right leg and right arm, if possible. Grab your block if you need it. Energize your back foot, Annie. Yes. Beautiful. Fill it with breath. And then inhale gracefully back into your reverse warrior. Come through the center, Kali Ma. The right toes turn out. The left toes turn in slightly. Lion's breath. To the back of the mat for one more peaceful warrior. Inhaling. Yeah. Triangle, exhaling. Slide your right hand down your shin as you lengthen the spine out of the hips. And then inhale the left arm overhead, gazing up underneath your left bicep. So the left hand's gonna circle down across the face. Turn your left toes back to the front of the mat. Bend your left knee. Skid your right heel toward the back of the mat. Other way, Paris. Yeah, there you go. So scooting your right heel away from your left heel may help you here. Use the back of your left arm to keep your knee headed over your toes, or grab a block and put it underneath your sitting bones. Tense your left fingers to the top of the mat. See if you can inhale the right arm up. Again, if you need your hands on the ground, keep them there. Wrap the arms around your back if you can for a bind, and keep lifting your chest. Take your arm on the inside of your leg. So it goes this way. Yes, you got it, and lift your chest. And then take your hands to the ground. Hallelujah. Pick yourself up, extended side angle to the front of the mat. So we're nice and low with this one. We've prepared the hip. We've gotten it really warm. Now bring your left arm on the inside of your left leg. And if your hand does not come flat to the ground, go inside, Liz. Yeah, then use your block. So just like we did in our warm-up, the left knee is gonna press against the upper left arm. Now see if you can scoot the heel back toward your sitting bone. Yeah, flying. Take your right hand down, tuck your right toes. Air tree to the left. So you're just turning right through space. Good, maybe step your left foot back, maybe wild thing. Offer it up. Last piece of the pie. Left hand down, left knee to the nose. Take your left foot to the outside of the right hand fallen triangle, breathing in. So you sort of skid out, yeah. And then finish it in your own magical way. As long as it's magical. Yes, Josh. Breathe, everybody. You step or hop to the top of the mat. Inhale, reach your heart forward when you get there. Empty into your legs, breathing out. Take your feet together for Utkatasana, inhaling. Stand tall for a moment. Pull the hands through prayer and open them by your sides. And slow down the breath. I'll even turn on a fan for you. So we're gonna move into the third chakra. Utkatasana, breathing in. Twist over to your right on your breath out. So left elbow to the outside of the right thigh. Roll your right shoulder back. Align your kneecaps and reach through the crown. Inhale, back up through center. Exhale over to the left side. We got this. City of shining jewels. So you're shining your solar plexus over to the left side of the room. Come back through center, breathing in. Utkatasana. Now you're going to sink extremely low. Take your knees apart and your hands out in front of you. Come up onto the balls of the feet, bring your knees onto the backs of the arms, curl the navel in and up, shift your weight forward, and see if you can lift one foot, maybe both feet, into Bakasana, crow pose. So lifting right from your navel center, right from your will, your inner strength, maybe downward dog, maybe chaturanga on your way out. Move with your breath. Yeah. Excellent. Meeting back in downward dog. Right leg to the sky, inhale. Draw the knee into the nose, step your foot forward to the top on your exhale. Keep the back heel lifted. Inhale the right arm up, take a little twist, right from your navel. You can even take your right hand on top of your right hip. Get a hold of yourself for a moment, yeah. So you're gonna guide the hip back. Now reach your left arm forward and up. Ooh, crescent pose. So you might take a breath into the front of the left hip and thigh there. And then cut the right arm underneath the left arm, eagle your arms in crescent pose. Yes. Weave the fingertips up overhead with a breath in. Now you're gonna take a twist to the right, breathing out. So use your elbows on the outside of the right thigh. Yeah, so you're just taking your eagle arms with you. Keep stretching through the crown of the head forward and through the left heel toward the back of the room. You might open your arms as long as you can keep your left arm on the outside of the right foot. So you might even tint your fingers or use a block. Yeah. Spiral through the spine and lengthen into your twist. One more breath in. Now take your hands back to either side of the right foot. Hop your left foot up a few inches, pyramid pose, breathing out. Yeah, horse breath might be nice here. So widen your right foot a little bit, Sin, this way, and take it forward. See if you can shift the weight evenly between your feet, hug the outer hips in, and pour out over the right leg. Oy. Yes. Lifting up through the inner leg lines, right up through Mula Bandha. Okay, we're gonna try something fun here, or at least I think it's fun. It's all relative, right? So the hands are on either side of the right foot. Keep your left foot where it is, and lift your right leg up behind you. So the front leg swings back. Bend the knee, roll the hip open. Now reach powerfully through the right hand. You might lift your gaze forward slightly. You're gonna try to catch your right foot with your left hand. Yeah, so right hand stays on the floor. Left hand reaches back for the foot. It's there somewhere, I promise. Yeah, and then see if you can lift your knee back behind you and your gaze forward. And hold yourself up from your bellies, right from your guts. Yeah, good. Let go of the right leg. Take your left hand down. Lift onto the ball of the left foot there. Three-legged chaturanga, or for some of you that want to go into Gandha Barandasana, you might bring your chest super far forward and hug the elbows in under the ribs. Yeah. We'll meet back in downward facing dog and take a moment. Yeah. Left leg lifts, breathing in. Step it to the top, breathing out. Inhale the left arm up. Take your hand to your hip, bless you, and connect to yourself there. Now the right arm reaches forward and up on the breath in, so feel length. Scoop right up out of the hips there. And then cross the left arm under the right arm. So your arms cross above the elbows, weave the fingertips overhead, breathing in. Now we're gonna turn from the belly to the left, bring your elbows to the outside of the thigh, and then stretch your heel back behind you, maybe opening the wings, keeping the right arm to the outside of the left foot. Yes, great. Rinse through the middle, everybody, keep it breathing. Into the side of the rib cage, the back of the rib cage. And then release your hands down to frame the left foot. Hop the right foot up a smidge. Keep it on the right side of the mat. Take a breath in to lengthen your spine. And then empty into your left leg for pyramid. Yes. Oh. See if you can turn your toes out just a little bit. Yeah. And then lift your left thigh. But keep the ball of the foot down. Oh. Yeah, medial hamstrings, hello. There are a lot of sneaky ways to avoid the medial hamstring opening here. Right. Now the right heel stays where it is. You're gonna free the left leg up behind you into a very short downward dog splits. Yeah, and then try bending the left knee, opening the hips slightly, not too much, because we don't want to tip off our center here. Reach into the left hand and see if you can catch the left foot with your right hand. Yeah, so you're lifting your gaze forward. Roll the right shoulder back a bit. There's a nice stretch through the pecs here secretly. Yes, Greg, great. Super strong belly, nice Ryoko. And then let it go, come high up onto the ball of the right foot as you extend the left leg behind you. You can come through three-legged chaturanga or something special I don't even know about. No. meat and child's pose. So we're gonna use our bellies to take it upside down. So you might be wanting to grab your blanket right about now. You can also fold your mat back like this to give yourself a little extra cushioning. If you have a neck injury, do not do a headstand. If you have a neck injury, you can interlace your hands and come into dolphin, keeping your head off the mat and lifting a leg, and maybe another leg. We're gonna try tripod today if your neck is healthy. So you can unfold your blanket in a nice rectangle shape, slide it to the edge of your knees, place your hands under the blanket, shoulder width apart, bend the elbows straight back so that the forearms kind of hug against the thighs. So if you look down, you're making nice parallel lines. And then you can lower your third eye down, roll up to the crown, tuck your toes, lift your knees, press into your hands, keep your elbows right over your wrists, walk the feet in. Maybe the knees come to the backs of the arms today. Maybe this is it today. Almost like an upside down crow. Yeah. Squeeze the elbows in. Sin, take your head further forward in front of your hands. So use your triceps to keep the elbows stacked over the wrists, the back of the neck long, the hips over the shoulders. Lengthen out through the lower back pares. Yes, darling. Some of you might feel tempted to bring your knees onto the backs of the arms and maybe rise up into crow. Hey. So a lot of that transition is about timing. Yes, pares, nice. Tipping the hips back just slowly enough to lift the head at the same time. Yes, and then lift your bandhas in and up, Jess. Great, and you can lower down and rest and roll around on your third eye a bit. Yeah, beauties. And you can use your blanket for your knees or the doubled up mat to protect the bones, the little patellas in the knees. You can tuck your toes for a moment and sit on your heels. Stack your shoulders over your hips. Breathe into the soles of your feet. You can take your arms down by your sides and we'll take a little swing. Just let your arms dangle a little bit. So we're gonna move the energy up from the third chakra into the fourth, into the fourth, into the fifth, the heart and the throat. So breathing in, lift yourself up. And then breathing out a little lion's breath. And keep your toes tucked. Breathing in, almost like a big back dive. And breathing out. Take your arms up nice and high, inhaling. Now this time as you sink your hips down, take your right hand to your right heel. And then circle your left arm across the face as you move your hips forward, breathing in. Whoosh. And then lower your hips back down, the left hand sweeps across the body to the left heel. And then roll the heart open, breathing in. And keep returning to center. So the hips sink back, you connect to your navel center for strength, and then circle it open. So it's a dancing camel, moving the energy all the way up through the heart into the throat to share the love. Yeah, and then maybe you take it all the way back into a full camel. If your hands do not come to your heels, bring your hands to your sacrum instead and try to maintain vertical stacking, hips over the knees. So just bring your knees together a little bit more so your thighs stay parallel. It's a little bit more manageable with the toes tucked, right? You've got a little bit more support there. Beautiful. And you can take your hands back to your hips or to your heart on the way up. Excellent, everybody. Cross your shins behind you. Yeah. And then sit back down. You can move the blanket off to the side, and you'll come forward in a tabletop. So breathing in, lift the hips. Lion's breath. Lower onto your back, so you can scoot your body forward a little bit. So keep your knees bent with your feet on the floor. And take a moment, maybe with one hand to the heart, one hand to the navel. And close your eyes. Feel the sacrum spread out onto the ground. Take up as much surface area as you can through your back body there. And then draw the heels in nice and close. So the heels are just in front of the sitting bones, feet hip width apart. Take your arms down by your sides. And then with an inhale, lift your hips up off the ground. And you can interlace your hands behind your back or take your hands around the edges of the mat. If the hands don't reach around that far, grasp a hold of the edges of the mat, lift the hips, keep the feet parallel, the inner thighs engaged. You might even root through the balls of the feet and flare the toe pads up. Yes. Stretching open the back of the neck, tipping the heart. Overflowing energy into the throat. Soften the throat as you breathe in and out through the nose. And then you can separate your hands and lower back down one vertebra at a time. Let the knees sway right to left. Release the lower back. So we'll take one more bridge, unless you're really feeling a bigger back bend, right? If your body's ready for Urdhva Dhanurasana, then you might stretch your hands to the sky, take a few circles of the wrists, and then plant the hands behind the shoulders. Now, if you have a wrist injury or an injury anywhere along the spine, you might want to stick with the low bridge instead. So I'll leave that up to you. Either a bridge, active, or passive with a block under the sacrum, or Urdhva Dhanurasana, full wheel, maintaining connection to your lower belly for support, breathing in and out through the nose for extra buoyancy and lightness. Bring your feet in a little bit. Yeah, there you go. And inner thighs working to keep the legs straight ahead. Nice. Chin into the chest on your way down, yogis. Get your head out of the way. And then we'll all meet on the ground. You can take your knees to the left and then to the right. And then bring your right knee into the chest and give it a squeeze. Stretch your left leg long, roll the shoulders down the back. Widen the collarbones. And then take your right knee across your body to the left and gaze over the right arm. You might have to bend the right elbow. And a little cactus arm if you don't have a lot of room. Yeah, left arm can drape over the right thigh to give it a little more weight. Yeah. And see if you can empty the right shoulder blade down into the ground as the hip releases down away from the rib cage. Come back onto your back and switch out your legs. You can bring the left knee into your chest. Extend the right leg long. And then bring it on over to the right side of the room as you gaze over to the left. To nudge the ribs slightly over to the right side of the mat. Breathing up and down the length of the spine. Mm-hmm. them back under your backs. Bring both knees into your chest. So you're gonna rock forward and back a few times and then come all the way up to sit with your legs long. Yeah, scoot your sitting bones back behind you. If you're a little tighter in the hips, you might even want to prop your hips up with a blanket. So we're going to empty into Paschimottanasana. So closing it down. If the feet feel too far away, you can use a strap around the feet, drawing the pinky toe edges of the feet back so you can feel an opening through the inner and the outer leg lines evenly. And then rest your tongue right behind the two front teeth against the roof of the mouth. And take a little space between your molars in the back. Let's see if the shoulders can release down the back away from your ears. You can come into a nice, slow, resonant breath practice, ujjayi, with a little whispering through the back of the throat. Just soft enough for you to hear it. You're bowing in. Honoring the gift that is your life. And embracing all that you are. Even the parts of you you have a hard time embracing, there they are. Love them up. You're gonna finish with fish pose. So if your blanket's underneath your hips, you're gonna move it out of the way. Slide your hands underneath your hips with the palms down and then lower onto your elbows. Lift your heart, tilt your chin up. See if you can rest on the crown of the head. If you're stable here on the base of the spine and the crown of the head, you might slide your hands out from underneath you and bring them to the heart. Spread out through the toes. If you're comfortable here, maybe the hands reach overhead like a fountain. So imagine this rainbow through your body from the base of the spine to the crown of the head. And then you can take your hands back down alongside the hips. Scoot your sitting bones forward with your hands to help you spread out into Shavasana. So the hands can open, the legs can roll out naturally. Give yourself a little room. So if you're being poured out on the ground like a glass of water, I assign you to be a beautiful, good, kind, awakened, soulful person. A true work of art, as we say, a true human being. In a world filled with so much darkness, such a soul shines like gold, can be seen from a far distance, is dramatically different. Anything you do from the soulful self will lighten the burdens of the world. You have no idea what the smallest word, the tiniest generosity, can cause to be set in motion. Be outrageous and forgiving. Be dramatic and reconciling. Mistakes, back up and make them as right as you can, then move on. Be off the charts in kindness. In whatever you are called to strive to, be devoted to it in all aspects, large and small. Fall short, try again. Mastery is made in increments, not in leaps. Be brave, be fierce, be visionary. Mend the parts of the world that are within your reach. To strive to live this way is the most dramatic gift you can ever give to the world. Consider yourselves assigned. Clarissa Pinkola Estes. And stretch your arms overhead, reach long through your legs. And you can bring your knees into your chest, give them a squeeze. And you can either roll to the right and press up to sit with your left hand, or rock up to sit, whichever feels like the best fit for you right now. Yeah. Legs crossed. Interlace your hands with the index fingers extended to the sky, like an antenna, right? Tapping in to your highest self and your purpose. Channeling spirit.
Namaste.